The Story of Tracy Beaker by Jacqueline Wilson. Dramatised by Georgia Pritchard.
Don't stop, never give up. Hold your head high and reach the top. Let the world see what you have got. Bring it all back to you.
Once upon a time, there was a little girl called Tracy Beaker. No, stop. That sounds stupid. Like a fairy story. I hate fairy stories. Elaine, my social worker,
says... You're always telling fairy stories.
She means fibs. If I was in a real fairy story, I'd put a bad spell on Elaine. I'd turn her into a... Or I'd make her ears ginormous and her eyebrows long and traily and her nose all warty. And every time she sat down, she'd go... Anyway, where was I? Once upon a time, there was a girl called Tracy Beaker. That's me. I was born a long, long time ago. And I'm now 10 years old.
The same as me.
That's Peter Ingham.
I'll be 11 on May the 8th as well.
Will you stop butting in and leave me alone?
Ugh.
It's true, though. He has got the same birthday as me, which is lousy.
No, it's brilliant. It means we're best friends.
We are not best friends, Peter. We're not even friends. And it's lousy sharing a birthday, because then we have to share a cake instead of having one each. Anyway, if you want to buy me a present for my birthday, the things I like best are dogs. No, bigger than that. No, bigger than that. Yeah. I want a massive dog like that, which could eat up all my enemies. I also like sweets. And crisps. And popcorn and chips.
Yum.
And burgers. And cake and ice cream and milkshakes.
Heaven.
And I like watching horror films. But nothing too scary. Of course, the thing I like most in the world is my mum. But I'm not sure where she is at the moment. When I grow up, I'm going to live in a massive house and have my own big bedroom. And I'll have a Mickey Mouse alarm clock. And I'll have...
Don't stop, never give up.
Stereos in every room.
Let the world see what you have got. Bring it all back to you.
And nobody would tell me off. And I'll have burgers for breakfast, lunch and tea. And I'll have a really fast car. Yeah. So I could whiz off and visit my mum whenever I liked. Or maybe I'll just have her living in the house with me. Yeah, that's probably what she'd want. Until then, I'll just need a foster family. But that's never gonna happen.
Now come on, Tracy. I know it must have been disappointing when things didn't work out with Julie and Ted, but you mustn't let it get to you. Sooner or later, we'll find the perfect placement.
Like a fantastically rich family with a swimming pool and...
Or just a nice, normal family. Or a nice, normal, single person, if they were really suitable.
Are you nice, Elaine?
I like to think so.
Are you normal?
Yes.
But you haven't got a boyfriend, have you?
What's that got to do with anything?
That means that you're nice, normal and single. So why don't you foster me?
Oh, Tracy! Oh, I can't do that. I've got a job, and I've got lots of children to look after as part of my job.
But
I couldn't.
You could. It would be fun, I promise.
I'm sure it would be lots of fun, Tracy, but it's not going to happen.
I was only joking. I'd never want you as a mum. You're stupid and boring and fat and wobbly. I'd rather stay here any day.
I can understand you being angry with me. So I think it's best if we leave it for now. And I'll see you next time.
She's gone. She tried to look like she didn't mind what I said, but she held her stomach in all the way to the door.
I never cry, but my eyes have gone all silly and watery. I'm probably allergic to fatty old Elaine. Good thing I'm not going to live with her then.
Try not to worry about a thing. Enjoy the good times life can bring. Keep it all inside you. Gotta let the feeling show.
If I were Louise, I'd much rather be my friend than Justin's. What's even more annoying is that when Justin first got here, Louise didn't even like her.
Don't make friends with Justin, Tracy. She's horrid.
What do you mean?
She's stroppy and she swears all the time.
Oh, shut up and shove off, you pig-faced, stinking-ass poo-bum.
See?
In Justine's first week here, she swore and mouthed off non-stop.
Blooming, stupid, stinking, fat-faced fool!
Until Sunday. Then she shut up. Her dad was meant to be visiting at 11. Justin started waiting for him at 8. 11 came and went. Then 12. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. Then it was dinner time, and she wouldn't eat any dinner.
Yuck! Not hungry!
I knew just how she felt. I've waited for my mum loads of times. Not anymore. I reckon she must have gone abroad. Maybe France.
Bonjour, ma petite Tracy.
Or Spain. She likes Spain.
Hola, Tracy. ¿Cómo estás?
No. I know where she's gone. Hollywood.
Lights, camera, action.
My mum's so pretty, she'd easily get into movies.
Take one. Tracy's mum looking glamorous.
You can't just hop on a bus and visit your daughter when you're thousands of miles away, can you? All the same. I always go a bit tingly when there's a knock at the door, just in case, so I could understand what Justin was going through. I didn't say anything. I just marched up and dropped a lollipop in her lap.
What did you give her one of your lollipops for? She's horrible.
I didn't give her the red one. I saved that for you.
Thanks, Trace.
It was great being best friends with Louise.
I don't care that I haven't been fostered.
Nor do I.
I think we should try not to be fostered. That way we can stay together.
Good idea. And we'll stay here till we're 18 and then we'll get a flat together.
Yeah, and we'll have loads of posters and toys and bunk beds.
We'll have a pair of bunk beds each, so we can both always have the top bunk.
I don't mind having a bottom bunk if you want to have the top bunk, Tracy.
It was great in those days, until Justin spoiled it all. I should have listened to Louise.
Why do we have to have that Justin hanging around all the time? I don't like her. She's dead tough.
Well, I want to be tough too. I'm tougher than Justin. And to prove it, I started using all the swear words Justin used.
Pig face, stinking ass, poo bum!
And then, all the younger kids picked them up too. Jenny wasn't pleased.
It's absolutely disgusting.
She asked Mike to have a word with me. He had lots of words. Mike always goes on and on and on about things. Blah, blah, blah.
We don't expect this sort of nonsense from you anymore.
Blah, blah, blah.
Blah, blah, blah. Blah. Rules. Blah, blah, blah. Responsibility.
Blah, blah, blah.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.